I've got an opportunity to test Niviuk's current high B wing, the Ikuma 2. Now the Ikuma 2's been out for a little while and I've flown it lots already, as has Nancy. But I want to test it a bit more, and I haven't managed to actually put a review out of this glider, which I'd like to, because I think it's an exceptional high B wing. It's a great glider. And also one of our customers who bought an Ikuma 2 for us has asked me to test something for him and report back. Okay, let's go fly. Welcome to the Flybubble Paragliding channel.
We are free flight experts and equipment specialists helping you get the best flying experience.
Easy peasy. And I've just been flying again the Ikuma 2. I've actually flown the Ikuma 2 a lot, and so has Nancy. We've both flown this glider a lot since it first came out, which was a little while ago. And we absolutely love the Ikuma 2. We think it's a fantastic high B wing, and it has a character all of its own on the ground. The Ikuma 2 inflates nicely and fills up with air quickly. Despite the relatively small sails, the inflation itself is very progressive. Comes up from low on the ground, doesn't have a tendency to sort of drop back and keep insisting to pull up. And actually you need to be a little bit careful on it. If you pull too hard, the glider will come up and build up quite a bit of speed. And if you're too heavy handed, it could pluck you in a stronger condition, stronger gustier conditions. You can launch it pretty much without the risers, but just a little lift on the risers and the glider comes up nicely. And as soon as you see it's coming up, you know this is the kind of glider that's going to keep coming up. So I really like the launch of it. You just need to be aware of that thing about, and a strong wind, don't pull it up too hard and move towards the glider. In the air, the Ikuma 2 has a really solid taut feeling to it. Right across the glider, it feels like, definitely this is a glider that feels like one wing. It feels like a blade, just solid all the way through, cutting through the air. I think it's quite exceptional like that in the high B class. It also moves forward into thermals very nicely. It seeks out the lift and it cuts into the thermals, which is really nice. In terms of performance, I think the Ikuma 2, even though it's been out a couple of seasons, has really excellent performance, really excellent glide, very good speed. It's quite quick on trim. You find yourself when you're gliding around with other gliders of lower gliders and of the similar level that you're catching up and overtaking the lower gliders, and at least keeping up with gliders of the same level and even a little bit above. In terms of handling, the Ikuma 2 is a real pleasure to fly. For me, this is one of the nicest handling paragliders around. It's got a really nice feeling on the brakes and a nice precision, and when you pull the brakes you just feel that nice conversion of energy, and the glider banks, rolls and banks and comes around. It doesn't excessively roll and bank. It's turning very efficiently and not over rolling, but it does roll and bank round, so you can turn it really tightly. Really more on the sporty side, because it has that nice bite in the turns, which is good. The Ikuma 2 climbs really well, exceptionally well. I'd say it's one of the better thermalers and climbers in the high B class, and actually it's competes really well. In terms of descent techniques, the Ikuma 2 does classic big ears perfectly well, and actually I find them going in pretty easily, a little bit firm on the pressure, and they come in, they're quite stable and sit in nicely, and you get a good descent rate. The other technique you can do with the Ikuma 2 that Niviuk also recommend to do is the B3s. So that's on the riser reaching out to the B3 line. It actually takes a little bit to work out which line it is. It's kind of the line just in from the Stabilo line. So it's, yeah, really quite physical. In fact, it's kind of like digging into my fingers a little bit. So I wish I'd had gloves on. But I could pull it in, but I wouldn't be holding it in without gloves on. I wouldn't be holding that in for very long. One negative of the Ikuma 2 is that it has fully unsheathed lines, which is the same for some other high B gliders. For some pilots who launch on sites that have particularly sort of scraggy, bushy launches that have lots of hawthorn and stuff like that, they find that the unsheathed lines are a problem for them. They just grab and catch on everything. So for some pilots, that might put them off, the fact that the glider's fully unsheathed lines. So let's have a look at the Ikuma 2 risers in detail. So at the bottom, we have nicely colour coordinated bottoms, port and starboard, the pulleys for the speed system, and their nice Ronstan pulleys, the usual ubiquitous Brummo hooks or sister clips. Going on to the A's here, you can see there's a nice green part on the A's to really make those stand out. All the lines of the Ikuma 2 are unsheathed, so right from the bottoms, colour-coded little sheaths on the bottom which also protect the lines. A nice webbing brake. They've gone for these, I call them 270 magnets. Slight little weakness of them is that if you're trying to pull them off and there's no tension on the line, as you can see here, you kind of need to use your thumb or something to pull it off. Swivels on their brakes, which is interesting. Some manufacturers have gone away from swivels. The brake line goes through a ceramic ring rather than the pulley. The Ikuma 2 is a fantastic all-round high B glider. It's an ideal wing for those, for pilots who are wanting to either upgrade from a low B to a high B. You want to, you're quite ambitious, and instead of going from a low B to a mid B, which is a sensible progression for many pilots, but some pilots, if you're a bit more ambitious and you're feeling like you want to take an extra jump, then you can move up to the high B class. And the Ikuma 2 is a great upgrade. For pilots who have been flying a mid B glider, say like the Fee Beat or the Skywalk Arak, and you're looking for a nice progression up, and then again, the Ikuma 2 is an excellent choice. I think a lot of pilots who used to fly C class gliders and maybe haven't been flying so much, or just feel like taking a little bit of a step back, will really enjoy the Ikuma 2. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this review of the Niviuk Ikuma 2. I've reviewed this glider, even though it's been out a couple of seasons already, so it's kind of a bit late. I've reviewed the Ikuma 2 because I think it's such a great glider. It's a really exceptional wing that I know has made very, very many pilots happy, and I'm sure will make many more pilots happy too. Ikuma 2 pilots, give us your feedback. I'm sure that a lot of you are going to share your love of the Ikuma 2. And these videos are all funded by Flybubble. They're made possible by our customers. Continue to support us by choosing to buy their equipment from us. Thank you very much. We have literally hundreds of videos on the Flybubble channel, so go and check that out. The reason we share all these videos and the Flybubble knowledge base, obviously it's our business, but we're trying to help the free flight community, because a better, safer free flight community is a better place for everyone and for us as well.